In this video, I'm going to discuss the linear and relative layout options available for us to design our graphical interface for our Android application. So to begin with, I'm going to go ahead and open up the activitymain.xml file. If I double-click that, it'll open up in the main window. And I do want to point out, if for whatever reason you've closed the Package Explorer or you do not see the Package Explorer and you're new to Eclipse, you can go ahead and open up the different windows by clicking on the Window menu, choosing Show View, and then selecting the window that you want. So I was just in Package Explorer, which is right there. I'll go ahead and close that now. Now that I have the layout opened in the main window, I'm going to go ahead and resize it so that I have a little bit more room to work. There we go. If you need more room, you can always expand the main window by clicking the Maximize button. And that'll just go ahead and collapse the other windows that were on the sides. If you're still having trouble seeing the activity window, you can always zoom in on it or zoom out. Now there are two tabs that are important when it comes to the layout. You have the graphical layout, which is what we see right here in the main window, and you also have the code, which is the XML file. So if I click on that, you'll see that both of these refer to your layout. This tab just happens to be the code of the layout, and this happens to be the graphical interface of the layout. So I'll switch back over. You'll notice that the default tag that opens it up is a relative layout, and I have a closing tag here. So tags will usually have an opening and a closing tag. The closing tag is identified by a forward slash before the tag name. The text view that's listed here has a closing tag right there. If I switch back over to the graphical layout tab here, now the relative layout allows us to drag over views or other objects, place them on our layout in relation or relative to other objects or to the borders. And so you can see as I move this around, and I'm just going to go ahead and let that go, it's going to be relatively aligned currently to the Hello World text that I have up here. So if I click back on the XML file, you'll see that I have two text views. Here's one, and here's the other text view. This text view currently has properties. Let me go ahead and hit enter on some of these here so that it's a little easier to read. There we go. This layout currently has properties that, or attributes that relatively align this to the text view up here. So you can see here, layout below, and it is referring to this particular text view. It's laying out below it. From the margin, it's down 70 density pixels, and it's to the right of the text view that I had up there. So this is relatively aligned to the text view that I have here and spaced down 70 density pixels. If I switch back over to the graphical layout, I'll find my object here. Now I'm going to go ahead and delete that object. Let's go ahead and change this now over to a linear layout rather than a relative layout. If I right click on the main window, I can choose Change Layout. And here are the different options that we have for layouts. The main layout I typically like to use is the linear layout vertical. And if I go ahead and click on that and hit OK, you'll see that it will change my view now, if I click on the code, to a linear layout with the orientation vertical. And here's the attribute right there that says vertical. How this works, let's go back over to the graphical option, graphical tab. How this works is it's going to allow us to drag objects, but place them directly below them in a column fashion. So if I let go, let's go ahead and drag another one over, you'll notice that it aligns the objects directly below them in a column. If I decide to switch back over to the XML, I can also make the changes in code. For instance, if I want the linear layout to be a horizontal linear layout, I can simply just change the word vertical to horizontal. And I will mention that if you want to press Control and Spacebar, that'll give you the options available when you're typing in the attributes to show you what you can choose. So there's horizontal. I'll just go ahead and select that and switch back over to my graphical layout. And there you can see that instead of it being in a column now, my views or my objects are all in a row, which is how the horizontal linear layout works. I don't like that, so I'm going to switch back over to the vertical. So now if I press the Control and Spacebar one more time, I can see I have two different options to choose from. I'll choose vertical. There we go. Now one other thing I want to point out, if you read through the lesson text, is the weight of objects while using linear layout. It's a little bit more tricky because I cannot drag an object down anywhere down here in the layout. It has to be directly below the ones above it. So what we can do is we can use weights. And if I switch back over here to the XML, I can go ahead and add additional attributes to the text view. So this is the first text view at the top. I can go ahead and just type in Android, colon, and then here are the options that I have to choose from. I want to choose the layout weight. If I double click on that, it'll go ahead and open it up. Now if I press the control space bar, it will not show anything. The reason for that is because I have to type in a number, and it's not going to list every possible number available. The default layout weight for objects is 0. So if we modify it, we have to go ahead and make a number larger than 0. So for instance, I'm going to use the number 1. So what's going to happen now is this. The second and third text views currently still have a layout weight of 0, and this one has a layout weight of 1. By modifying this text view, I've now told it to fill all the empty space available on this particular text view and leave these as the default. Let me show you what I mean by that. If I click on the graphical layout, you'll see that the hello world now has filled the entire empty space and pushed the other two down to the bottom. Let's switch back over to the code. And I want to add the same attribute to the second text view. Android colon layout underscore weight equals, and then we're going to go ahead and put a 1 value in here as well. And switch back over to the graphical layout. And you'll notice now that the first text view and the second text view both have a weight of 1. So they have both equally expanded to fill all of the empty space. And you still have the bottom text view, which has the default weight of 0. So let's go ahead and go back to the code. And I'm going to go ahead and add Android. And I'm going to choose the layout weight. And I'll choose 1 for that one as well. And switch back over to the graphical mode. And you can see now here, all three of these have been set to a weight of 1, which means they all equally divide the empty space or the unused space among the objects. Now let's go ahead and change some of the numbers and see if it makes sense to you. I'll switch back over to the code, and I'm going to go ahead and choose 2 for this text view. These still currently have 1, and let me show you what that will do. The first text view is going to take up twice as much space as all of the other ones, and what I mean by that is this had a weight of 2. This has a weight of 1 and a weight of 1. Now if you add these two up together, that's a total of a weight of 2. And this has a weight of 2. So this particular text view takes up as much space as this one and this one, because they both have, because these two total 2 and this one is 2. It may be a little confusing, but I encourage you to try different weights until you understand how the text views work. I'm going to go ahead and close the activity main now, and I'm going to choose not to save any of the options that I've just added, because I want to use this again for the next lesson.